Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create a vintage black and white CRT TV interference glitch. This is an update of tutorials I've done on earlier versions of Photoshop. I provided this image of a shape of a cathode ray tube TV screen. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, hit that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. If I've helped you learn or improve in Photoshop and you'd like to help support my channel, become a channel member by clicking the join button below the video or become a patron by clicking the Patreon card at the upper right. Either way, you'll be helping to keep my tutorials free. Open a photo of someone or something that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. To ensure that the setting amounts will have similar results as mine, check your photo's size and resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 72 pixels per inch and its width and height somewhere in this neighborhood. To place the photo onto the TV shape I provided, make sure your Move tool is open. If it isn't, press V on your keyboard. Drag the photo onto the tab of the TV shape. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift, drag it down, and release. Pressing Shift kept your photo centered. Unlock the TV shape layer and drag it above your photo. Change its blend mode to Multiply. If you want to resize your photo inside the shape, make your photo active and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll create scan lines. Make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with 50% gray. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window, or you can go to Edit and Fill. Open the Contents list and click 50% gray. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they're not, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is line, the size is 1, and the contrast is 49. Change the blend mode to Soft Light. Because CRT TV monitors were not in high definition, all the images on the TV tended to have a soft blur to them. We'll blur the scan line slightly, but before we do, we'll convert it into a smart object so we can affect it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Then go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the effect. We'll convert our photo into a smart object as well, so we can modify it non-destructively, and if we decide to replace the photo with a different one, we won't have to redo any of the effects. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. We'll blur it 2 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. This removes all the color. Since CRTV images also tend to be a bit brighter in the center, we'll give our images a soft vignette along the edges. Make the photo layer active and go to Filter and Lens Correction. Open the Custom tab and drag the vignette slider all the way to the left. To make the vignette stronger, open the last filter by pressing Alt-Control-F on Windows or Option-Command-F on a Mac. As before, click the Custom tab and slide the vignette all the way to the left and the midpoint to plus 25, or you can just type it in. We'll convert our photo with all its effects into a smart object. Click the black and white adjustment layer and shift-click the photo to make both active. Then, convert them into one smart object. Make two copies of the photo by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. We won't be using the bottom layer from here on out, but it's always a good idea to keep one layer unmodified just in case you want to use it at a later point. Hide that layer and temporarily hide the top photo as well. Make the middle photo active and go to Edit, Transform, and Skew. Go to the top middle anchor point and drag it to the right, which skews your photo. Then press Enter or Return. Make two copies of the skewed layer and then hide the top copy. Make the middle skewed layer active and change its blend mode to soft light and its opacity to 50%. Press and hold Shift as you click the left arrow on your keyboard a few times to move the layer to the left. Shift-click the skewed layer under it to make it active as well, and press and hold Shift as you drag them to the left. Make the top skewed layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to soft light and reduce its opacity to 70%. Press and hold Shift as you drag it to the right. I'd like to get rid of the darker shape over the face, and if you have areas you'd like to eliminate, click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. We'll adjust the size in a moment. The hardness is 0%, and I'll make the opacity and flow 100%. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the unwanted area to mask it out. Make the photo above it visible and active. Make three copies of it and temporarily hide them. Go to Filter, Distort, and Shear. Drag the middle vertical line at various points to warp your image. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and make sure the Add To icon is active. This will allow you to add multiple rectangular selections on the same layer. Drag the tool over different areas of your image to make selections over it. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections next to the active layer. What's happening is that the white rectangles in the layer mask are revealing the sheared image, while the black areas of the layer mask are being masked out, thereby revealing the layers under it in the Layers panel. Collapse the effect and make the layer above it visible and active. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Shear. To reset the Shear filter, press and hold Ctrl or Command. The Cancel button instantly changes to default. Keep pressing and holding Ctrl or Command as you click the default button. This resets the Shear filter. Drag the vertical line to various points to create another sheared effect. We'll add an inverted layer mask next to the active layer by Alt-clicking or Option-clicking the layer mask icon. This masks out or hides the new sheared layer. We'll reveal back areas of it By dragging your rectangular marquee tool across your image, we'll fill the selection with white, and since your background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. This immediately reveals the new shared image through the white areas of your layer mask. Deselect it and collapse the effect. Make the layer above it visible and active. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. Feel free to experiment with the settings, however, I'll make the number of generators 402, the wavelength 1 and 2, the amplitude 1 and 106, and the scale both 100%. The type is sine, and the undefined areas repeat edge pixels. Make an inverted layer mask next to the active layer. Drag a vertical rectangular selection over your image and fill it with white. Then deselect it. Make the layer active and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Collapse the effects. Make the top face layer visible and active, and go back to Filter, Distort, and Wave. I'll drag the slider of the number of generators all the way to the right. For the wavelength, I'll type in 798 in the minimum field, and I'll click the maximum field. Immediately, the maximum field fills with 799. For the amplitude, I'll type in 998 in the minimum field, and I'll click the maximum field. This automatically fills it with 999. For the scale, I'll type in 1 in the vertical field. As soon as I click OK, the vertical scale changes to 1%. This creates thin, stacked horizontal lines. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.